Ready for medical career growth? Yes, you are in the right place. Hello, this is Dr. Neema Bish, BDS by degree and a pharma professional. As a founder of Career in Pharma, our mission is to guide medical professionals towards remarkable success in the pharma industry. With a track record of over 700 plus students trained and placed into various premier pharma companies, we are here to elevate your journey. Everyone, once again, I welcome you all to Career in Pharma. So in today's video, I'm going to explain you is really MSc in clinical research, pharmacovigilance and regulatory affairs is required to make a career inside pharmaceutical industry or not. So that I'm going to clarify you through this video, because there is a lot of buzz around masters in clinical research and pharmacovigilance. Lot many universities, they provide this course. But before taking this course, you should be very clear if you are an ideal candidate for this or not. Because many times, you know, without doing their own research and just to grab the master's degree, people do this master's and they don't realize that doing just master's won't help you. Main part is job. If even after doing master's, you are not getting job, then there is no point, right? See, if you want to simply add degree and degrees to your profile, then definitely you can go for it. But if you're really looking for a job, then it's really required or not, that I'm going to clear with this video today. So let's begin. See, first of all, Masters in Clinical Research and Pharmacovigilance is a good course. I'm not saying course is not good. You can pursue your masters, but it is not required for each and every people. So now let me tell you who requires and who don't requires. First of all, if you ask me, is it required? So I will tell you frankly, no, is it not required? It is not mandatory. There is no compulsion by companies, by pharma companies, by industry that you should be masters in clinical research and pharmacovigilance. So definitely not required, but still, who should go for this masters in clinical research? So if you are a life science graduate, with your graduation in zoology, biology, botany, microbiology, then you can think of doing masters in clinical research and pharmacovigilance, because it will give you end-to-end understanding of the entire field, entire pharma field and entire clinical trial, how it happens, pharmacovigilance, all the things, you will get a good understanding. Now, why good understanding is required for you? Because being from a life science graduation background, where you don't know what is clinical research, where you don't know what is a medicine, how it works, what is a pharmacovigilance, you don't have any subjects inside your graduation, then definitely you can go for masters in clinical research and pharmacovigilance. But that also not compulsory. If you feel that you have an enough basic understanding of the field, then also you can also go for some short courses, then also not compulsory that you should go for masters, but yeah, taking masters will be an added advantage for you considering your degree. But for people who are already healthcare professionals, let's say dentist, Ayurveda graduates, homeopathy graduates, nursing graduates, physiotherapist and pharmacy graduates, biotechnology graduates, for them really masters in clinical research pharmacovigilance is not required, not at all, unless and until you want just an additional degree. For job purpose, it is really not required. Any short course of 1 to 2 months is more than sufficient. Yeah, for healthcare professionals and pharmacy graduates. Now, very crucial question is, what is the length of any course should be? Because many people many times thinks that if they will go for some lengthy courses, it will be more beneficial. See, nothing like that. This is something in our mind. We think that if something is taking more time, then definitely it is more fruitful. Nothing like that. Let me tell you one thing frankly. Whatever they ask in interview, if you go through that basic things only, that you can very easily prepare in just 10 to 15 days. So any course which is just 1 to 2 months is more than sufficient to get a job inside this field. Yes, no need to dwell into deeper things which interviewer never going to ask you. Yeah, in any interview, they are going to ask you just basic things, because details you will already learn inside the job. So don't think that if you know more, if you know more deeper things, then your selection is final. No. More than your knowledge, what gives you job and is more important is how much flexible you are, how much open you are, learn to new things. The psychology the interviewer will get to know through your answers. Okay, so don't think more knowledge you have, more probability of getting chances. Nothing like that. Yeah, because there are many people who have so many degrees in their hand, but still they don't have a job inside this field. So nothing like that. Yes. Now regarding offline or online, see, in today's technology driven world, when interviews are happening virtually, everything is online. There are many benefits of online. It saves your time, it gives you more focus, and from the time which you save, you can use that time into your own personality development and many things which required for any job hunting candidate. Yeah, you can make your LinkedIn profile, you can make more and more connections, so no need to go for, you know, offline or physical classes. Online will serve the purpose, but if you are someone who need more motivation or people around you, then definitely you can go for offline courses. Otherwise, online courses are also equally beneficial. There is no doubt on that. Everything depends on candidate seriousness and commitment. Doesn't matter if it's online, offline, 2 months, 3 months, 1 year, 2 years. If you are really a serious and committed candidate, you can get job within just 1 to 2 months. If you are not serious, even 2 years will not be sufficient to land a job. Yeah, so please keep this thing in mind. Your seriousness and commitment is very, very important. Now, if you are planning to take masters in clinical research and pharmacovigilance, then from where to do this? See, any renowned university who is giving decent placement, yeah, see, no university or institute can give you job guarantee. But if they have decent placement, you can go with them, and they have good name, then you can go with them. But please don't forget that ultimately it's your responsibility. No institute, university, college is responsible for your job. And if you are doing the process, if you are following the process, definitely no one can stop you from grabbing the job also. So any decent university you can select. Now during the course, because if you are going for masters, it will be minimum for a year. Okay, so during that course itself, what other things you have to keep in mind so that as soon as you finish your course after a year, you should be having job in your hand. So other things which you can focus on is in your job hunting part, where you can focus on LinkedIn, you can focus on Naukri, you can focus on Indeed, you can grow your network inside LinkedIn, you can make more and more connections, relevant connections inside LinkedIn, you can be in contact with the recruiter, consultants, employee of the company. So that process along with the learning part you have to do along with your MSc in clinical research and pharmacovigilance. So this is all about if it's really required MSc in clinical research or not. I hope this video was able to clear your doubts whether you should go it for or not. Okay, especially if you're a pharmacy graduate or a healthcare professional, then from my end it's a big no for MSc clinical research and pharmacovigilance, because guys, you already have a professional degree with you, a pharmacy and healthcare professionals, that is having an immense potential and value. Yes, so no need to go for MSc, but yes, for life science graduates you can think of and you can go for this. Now one pro tip for job, very important. The day you will realize that your job is your responsibility, and if you take any course from wherever you are doing, if you take it very seriously, if you are 100% committed, then let me tell you, no one can stop you in getting job. So that is the pro tip. Take responsibility of your life and your job. Yes. So with this, I'm going to conclude this video, and I hope you really like this video, and I hope that this video helped you in getting clarification on if MSc in clinical research and pharmacovigilance is required or not. So we'll be coming soon with some fresh next video. Till the time I come again, till that time, please stay safe, aware, updated, and don't forget to exploring new things. Thank you for watching.